Hello. In this video, I want to talk to you about the presentation that you would need to do in terms of your valuation and risk analysis. So thinking about the fact that at this stage you have done your revenue forecast, your expense forecasts, you've calculated investment values, terminal values, asset investment requirements, you've calculated a present value under a certain set of assumptions for your business idea. And you've done a sensitivity and scenario analysis. And so really you're coming to the point where you've done most, if not all, of the analysis that you can do at this point. And so imagine that you want to present that. Now, what I am expecting is that, as we talked about before, that each presentation sort of builds on the prior ones. And so I'm simply adding the present value, sensitivity, and scenario analysis to the presentation you did in step eight. But while I want all of that stuff to be in here so that you can, we can refer back to it and so forth, I need that you do two things with this. One, I need that if you have made some sort of an assumption change, or if your, for example, your revenue or your operating cash flow charts are different, I need you to just highlight those things, maybe highlight them with a yellow highlight or something so that draws your attention to it. And really only focus the talk that you spend on that part of it to that. I don't want you to spend 25 minutes going back through things that you've already presented in other discussions, right? But for example, if your cash balances are significantly different because you had an error in your prior presentation, and you want to correct that, then you would want to flag that and make some sort of a note to that effect. Otherwise, you're really going to just go through the first part of it and say, same business concept, happy to answer questions about that if anybody has them. The assumptions are effectively the same. We did make a couple of slight changes. Here's what they are. The revenue forecast is similar to the last time. We made these changes to the operating cash flow forecast, whatever. And so, kind of bang, 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 probably 2 minutes on that, unless somebody has a question. And then jump kind of down to the present value analysis. And what you want to do is you want to have some sort of a slide for them that explains why you're doing an analysis. You're trying to effectively estimate what the business opportunity might be worth. And so, completely separate from the issue of you've got to raise some capital for it is, assuming you raise the capital for it, what would somebody be willing to buy it for? Not invest in it as the capital investor, but buy the whole concept from you for. And so that's what you calculated, and you can see in my example it was about $1.24 million. Then you want to talk to them about the sensitivity analysis, what exactly you did. Show them your chart. I did reformat this slide instead of having a big title across the top. I like to be able to see the sensitivity analysis spread out enough that you can see what's going on. So I would prefer that you kind of rearrange the page for that. And what you want to talk about here is you do want to talk about what you found to be the important variables that you are then going to speak to from a scenario standpoint. And you might want to make some comments about why, for example, when the weighted average cost of capital goes up, that the present value goes down, whereas when the average dollar per customer goes up, the present value goes up, and so the negatives and positives just a little bit. But enough to let us know, from my standpoint, enough for me to know that you know that your model is working properly. But from an investor standpoint, you really want to talk about this so that they get a sense of why these particular variables are driving your results in the way that it is. It will give them a little bit more intuition about what's really going on inside of your business, where the real risks are, where the things are that they're going to want to focus on. So again, you don't have to go down everything, just kind of figure out, draw your line, if that's, staff on campus, a typical day or whatever that is, wherever it is for you, you draw your line and basically say, that's as far as I'm going, and I don't need to speak to anything beyond that. Then you would talk about from the sensitivity analysis, again, which ones you really decided to do. I prefer, as I showed in my example, that you group them by revenue, expense, and investment factors, so that we can, as investors, can think in terms of that. And then do your scenario analysis. Again, this is just an explanation of what that is. But you want to put it up there, talk about what your three scenarios are, why you picked the values you picked for the variables, and why you think those reflect those scenarios, and then talk about the range of values that you get. Obviously, in my example, there's a pretty huge difference between my likely scenario and my bad scenario and my good scenario. You want to talk about what you think is really driving that. And at the end of the day, the goal for you in making this presentation is that you should have the rest of us better understanding how important certain factors are to the result, and how much risk there is, and you know, any thoughts you have on how you might manage that or how realistic you think it is. So that's kind of where we're going with this. And that's really it. Understand that from my standpoint, the purpose of this is that this valuation risk analysis will serve as the basis for us to have a negotiation about cost and capital. And so I want you to be presenting it in a way where you are informing me as though I am a potential investor who's thinking about what I might or might not be willing to invest in at what rates in your business in order to make this happen. So anyway, that's kind of the gist of this. And obviously, you're going to want to ask questions, all sorts of things, to get this together. Your projects would be very different than these, but I want to give you just a sense here of what I want you to present and where I want your focus to be. I hope that's useful. Again, come to class with any questions.